Our last presenter will be Vladimir Smotlaka from ChessNet. And he will present us one-way delay measurement with NTP and what their observation, how can we measure one-way delay more easily with using NTP. Finally.
Good morning. I'm going to speak about one-way delay measurement using NTP synchronization. One-way delay, as it is defined in document RFC 2679, it is a time difference between two events. It is the occurrence of last bit on wire at the receiver side and the occurrence of first bit of packet on wire at the sender side. Such a definition reflects the one-way delay at physical layer, and it is definitely rather complicated to measure it without some specialized hardware. In practice, one-way delay is measured on application layer when one application, the sender, assigns timestamp, another application, receiver, assigns the second timestamp, and the one-way delay is just difference of these two timestamps. The advantage of this second method is that the timestamp of sender can be included into the packet, and therefore any more channel is not necessary for the calculation of one-way delay. However, there is still one big problem. As the timestamps are evaluated by two different clocks at two different systems, it is the problem of time synchronization between these two systems. Well, how to synchronize clock? Generally, there are two possibilities. The one is to provide the box with some external clock, for instance by a cesium clock or by receiver of some transmitted clock information, as it is part of navigation systems like GPS or LoRaN or WWE. The problem is that such a solution is rather expensive and it is not scalable. In many locations is quite problematic to install the receiver, and for instance the GPS systems requires the antenna located outside the building, as the signal is not available inside building. The second solution is to synchronize clock via network by NTP protocol. This solution is perfectly scalable, however the accuracy of synchronization is worse, and even more it is complicated to estimate the exact accuracy. Well, as far as concerns the method of NTP, it is based on a simple exchange of two packets. The client sends the request and the server responds. There are assigned four timestamps to these events, and at the client side it is possible to calculate the total propagation delay delta, and another parameter which can be calculated is the mean value of offset of two clocks, the clocks of sender and receiver, the clocks of client and server. However, such calculation is based on the assumption of the same propagation delay in both directions, and in worst case we need to know the interval of uncertainty, and unfortunately the width of such interval is just the total propagation delay. In NTP server there are several sources of inaccuracy. The first one is the internal source, as NTP is implemented as a digital locked loop, and such loop has tries to minimize the offset of local clock. Therefore the offset of clock, the estimation of that clock offset is known to the system, and system can tell us his estimation about it. Another source of inaccuracy are the influences of network. Some of them can be filtered. It is, for instance, the jitter of propagation delay. Unfortunately, there is another source of inaccuracy, and it is the permanent long time difference in propagation delay, the asymmetry, and such feature can be filtered, and it is not possible for NTP system to know about it. The configuration of NTP for our purpose, for the measurement, requires the best available accuracy. It is a rather different configuration than the default, which is oriented to the better stability, to the maximum robustness of system. Therefore, in our case, we use only one NTP server per client, per box, per size of measurement, and we limited the polling interval, as this is the interval in which the client sends its requests. In standard configuration, the interval is is limited by some higher value, about 1,000 second, and it is still adjusted, and it used to be greater and greater, while for our purpose it is required to limit it. Several papers suggested to use the interval about 1 minute, and we proved that it is quite a good value to just back to the measurement of one-way delay. We designed several setups of the measurement system. The first one is the setup where each box of measurement is provided by its own NTP server on the local network, and in this setup the round trip time between the site of measurement and the NTP server was less than 1 millisecond. In the second setup we used only one common NTP server located in the search network. We did the measurement between CESnet and HANET, it means the NRN of Czech Republic and Ireland. In the second setup, the NTP server was located in Slovenia, just in the middle of the network. Definitely that this cloud is a giant network, as both NRN are connected via giant. During the measurement, we stored three pairs of information, three pairs of parameters. The first one are timestamps, as they are reported by application, timestamp of packet sending and packet receiving. The second stored information was the offset reported by NTP client, and the last one was the timestamp of exact external PPS signal. In order to compare our measurement with exact value of one-way delay, we provided both boxes with external PPS signal. From these values we calculated one-way delay, and we calculated just three values of one-way delay. The first one is one-way delay. This is just a simple difference between timestamps of packet receiving and packet sending. The second one is one-way delay corrected by known values of NTP offset. And the last one is the exact one-way delay, which were evaluated for the comparison. Just to the results. In the first setup, we got results which are displayed here. On the left picture are two values of one-way delay, two measured values. The green dots represent the exact one-way delay, while the red dots are the measured one-way delay. When we compare it with recalculated one-way delay, we see that these values correspond much better to exact one-way delay than the measured one-way delay. Well, it is probably not readable. The scale of y-axis is 20 millisecond. Therefore, we see that the error of recalculated one-way delay was about 500 microseconds during the whole interval of the measurement. The interval of measurement was about 8 days. Here is the results of the second setup. We expected much worse result, but much worse accuracy, but still the error is smaller than 1 millisecond. Here is interesting this situation, which means that the NTP server was not accessible for about 6 hours, and we see that it took another about 6 hours to the system until it returns to the original accuracy. Here are results of the same measurement with only one small difference. In setup 2A, we didn't apply the limitation of polling interval, and we see that the accuracy is much more worse than in the previous measurement. Therefore, the limiting of polling interval is really important. Well, and here is for comparison the last measurement setup. We arrange at the testnet site, it is the box B, the asymmetric routing, as the normal traffic is routed via Giant, but we change the routing to HANET via the Telia network. Telia is testnet. It provides the SNAC community internet traffic, therefore we have two international lines. And we use only one NTP server located at HANET. It means that in this setup was used the same path for both measurement and for NTP synchronization. And as we can see, this setup is quite unusable, as the systems didn't about the asymmetry in one-way delay, and therefore it the system reported the same mean value of one-way delay in both direction, while the real value differs. Another interesting result are these peaks. It is regular daily load at the Telia network, while we can see that GIA network is really over-provisioned. There are no peaks. Well, conclusions. We can conclude that the first setup is quite good suitable for one-way delay measurement. The accuracy which we can reach is in the order of several hundreds of microseconds, and it requires only one thing: the good NTP server on in the same local network as the box of measurement. The second setup is still usable for one-way delay measurement. However, we can select careful NTP server, and the system is sensitive to good NTP configuration. The third setup is definitely not usable for one-way delay. And as far as concerns our suggestions for NTP configuration for this purpose, never time can be used multiple NTP servers per one NTP client. The NTP server has to be selected very carefully. It is preferred server located close the box of measurement, and with symmetrical propagation delay. And definitely it is important to adjust the Pauli interval and to limit it. Well, it's all. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much. Are there any questions?
Yes. Do you plan to deploy this architecture, or maybe it's already deployed within testnet, or it's just the pure testing?
Definitely, it is maybe the question for Dante if to deploy it in the JAN network or not. In testnet, we don't need to deploy it as we have at first the right box for measurement. And it is not necessary to deploy it now.
Perhaps to add a little bit on that, I think the solution with NTP server is possible when, for instance, you have a housing site where you're not allowed to get a GPS on your roof or where the windows have that reflecting layer on it. So then you can put your GPS somewhere else and then use NTP towards the measurement box. Because sometimes you have to pay quite a lot of money to get roof access. So that's how perhaps JANT or other networks could use this methodology.
Okay, thank you very much again for the presenters. And now the break and after plenary sessions.